Jack left home on Wednesday morning and was with his owners the whole time. He stayed in a hotel on Wednesday night, attended Crufts with us on Thursday. We had the most fantastic day at Crufts. It's the most amazing show. And the only time he was left alone was while he was on his bench while other dogs were being exhibited. That is quite a normal thing to happen at shows. There's nothing untoward about that at all. When he got home on Friday, the dog became ill. He subsequently collapsed and died before the vet got to him. The vet was quite suspicious, we understand, that his symptoms weren't for a normal type of illness, so she took him straight to her clinic and performed a post-mortem. She found, and this is what we have been told, she found undigested pieces of beef still in his stomach that had been stuffed with poison, which as yet is unidentified. And we are waiting now for the toxicology report to just tell us what kind of poison it was. But we are led to believe there is no doubt that the dog was maliciously poisoned.
And how do you feel about that, Dee?
I am so saddened. I really, really am. But it is the way of the world these days. I don't believe in my heart of hearts that this was another competitor or was anybody to do with the dog world. We are all going to dog shows to have fun with our dogs and to ultimately win. But the most important thing for everybody that not was only competing at Crufts, but we do this week in, week out, we all love dogs. And there's one thing that has been proven within the dog world over years and years and years. When the chips are down for any exhibitor or breeder, people pull together, and they pull together worldwide. If you could see my inbox and my telephone messages from support from people all over the world for the loss of a dog, the loss of a family pet,